Hi everybody, can you hear me? You can send message through Slack if you can hear me. Just yes is enough. Okay, perfect. During the live session, we will use Slack to communicate. Please don't send any message through Zoom chat, because I will not check them. It is taking time to check two different platforms. Just Slack will be enough for messaging. Okay. Welcome to our Salesforce bootcamp. This is our seventh batch. We graduated many students from our Salesforce bootcamp. Some of them got offers from the market. Some of them are still looking for new positions in the market. And we have a couple of ongoing batches. They are still learning Salesforce details. This is our first day in Salesforce Bootcamp. Today, we will do orientation because some of you is new in a bootcamp. Some of you is new in online courses. I will tell you some important things about bootcamp and about online courses. And then we will talk a little bit about programming language and Apex. Then we will start to type simple codes, which are about variables. On the announcement channel, I shared slides. You can check it right now. You should create a Salesforce developer account for yourself, because most probably after the lunch, we will start to type code on Salesforce developer console. If you don't have account, you cannot type the codes. And if you have any issue to create Salesforce developer account, our technical support team can help you. But it is very easy and it takes just 3 or 4 minutes. All steps are in slides. You can follow them. Okay. Okay. First one, in boot camps, especially in online boot camps, is attendance. It is must. If you don't attend live session, most probably after a couple of weeks, you will give up. For example, today we have 5 hours, 20 minutes live instruction. If you don't attend today's class, you cannot understand tomorrow's subject, because in IT, every subject related with each other. If you miss today's live sessions, you have to rewatch recordings until tomorrow 10 a.m. But it is 5 hours, 20 minutes. When will you watch that recordings? You will not have time. If you wake up at midnight and if you watch them until the morning, and then you will be sleepy on Sunday, and the live session on Sunday will not be effective for you. It will be difficult to understand Sunday sessions. Attendance is must. Please set your schedule according to the boot camp schedule and be on time for every live session. Second thing, everybody, you should listen to the instructor carefully and you should be active listener. Who is active listener? Active listeners should attend to live session. This is must. Without attending live session, you cannot be active listener. This is the first thing. Second thing, while you listen to the instructor, you should take notes. You can take notes on a regular notebook, or you can use Microsoft Word or Sublime Text Editor. Whatever you want, you can use. But you should take notes. It is very important. If instructor tells you that part is very important, you should take notes. If instructor tells you that part can be asked in an interview, you should take notes. Actually, me and our instructors will put notes and share them with you during the live session, but typing by yourself is more effective than copying and pasting. If you type important parts by yourself, it will be good to learn. Another thing to be active listener, you should stop to be shy. I know all of you are adults and it is difficult to tell I couldn't understand for an adult. I know it. But please stop being shy during the boot camp. If you couldn't understand a specific part, please ask it. You will ask the questions on Slack channel. I have two monitors in front of me right now. On one monitor, I have Slack messages. I am following them. In the other monitor, I am typing codes. Most probably, I will not miss your questions on the Slack channel. But sometimes I am focusing on a part to teach. I am looking at just my own monitor for 7 minutes, for example. You may ask during that 7 minutes a question, it is possible, and maybe I will not see it, or I will make you wait to get the answer for the question. No worries, everybody. Be patient. I will reply your questions. If I missed, no need to think like that. Mr. Süleyman is ignoring me. No, I don't know anyone among you. I don't ignore anybody. If I missed any question, you can ask it again. This is the other feature of, other characteristic of active listener. When you ask a question, I will reply it. You couldn't understand. I will explain one more time. Again, you couldn't understand. I will explain one more time. But I will not explain anything more than three times. Why? Because I can teach a subject in four different ways at most. Fifth way will be the same with the first way. Fourth way will be the same with the second way. No need to waste time to tell same things again and again. I will tell you that's enough. I explained once and repeated three times. It is four in total. I cannot explain that subject in different ways more than four. It is impossible for me. Could you please rewatch the recordings. If you cannot understand from the recordings as well, you will have recap sessions. You may ask your recap instructor to teach that part again. It is possible. Or it is really difficult part. You couldn't understand. You can ask it to your friends one by one, because every student is in a different level, as you know. A part will be difficult for you, but it will be very easy for someone else. You can get help from your friend. After a couple of days, he cannot understand a part. You will understand it well. You will help him. You can help each other. On Slack, we created a channel. Its name is Helping Each Other Channel. You can send a message over there. For example, I couldn't understand for loop. Is there anyone who wants to help me? Most probably, some of your friends will help you. No worries about it. At the end, you can reach me out. I am not telling you reach me out at the first step, because there are many students. It is being impossible to reply all students' questions. But after following those steps, if you couldn't solve the issue, I can help you. No worries about it. Okay. Another thing, everybody, to be active listener, you should type quotes what your instructor is typing during the live session. If I typed system debug high, for example, this is an Apex code. I typed that one. You have to type it by yourself. Some students are being very slow in keyboarding, especially in first weeks. It is very normal, no worries. But you cannot make your keyboarding fast, everybody. You cannot make your keyboarding fast without typing codes. You should type the codes. Nope, Nuri, it is created. If you look at the channels, you will see it. I am seeing right now. You should type codes, but in the first weeks, after I type my codes, I will share the codes on Slack channel. No worries about it. But don't think like that. Mr. Süleyman is sharing the codes. I will not type. When he shares the code, I will copy and paste it. If you do copy and paste, your copying and pasting ability will improve. But to get offer, you should improve your coding ability, not copying and pasting. Okay? To improve your coding ability, you have to type code. To improve your English speaking, you have to speak. By reading, you cannot improve your speaking. If you want to improve your coding ability, please type code. It will be difficult at the beginning, I understand. You will forget semicolon, you will forget a character, you will forget to put that. You will tell, Mr. Süleyman, I did same with you. Yours is working, but mine is not. You will frustrated many times in the first weeks, but please insist on code typing. You will see after 2 weeks, typing code is very easy. I can do everything in coding. Okay. Please be active listener. Third one and fourth one, everybody, daily reviews. Today, you will have 5 hours, 20 minutes instruction. After live sessions, You should review your notes. I told you, active listeners take notes during the live session. You should review your notes. And you should review your codes as well. If you have some parts which you think it is not clear for you, you can rewatch the recording. If you think, everybody, if you think, for example, for loop is not clear, I couldn't understand it in live session, find the for loop part in the recording and watch it by pausing. For example, I asked a question about for loop without watching its solution. Try to type the codes by yourself. You will do some mistakes and then see the solution. Try to understand your mistakes. And then again, you try to type the solution without looking at the solution. If you study like that, everything will be clear for you. Okay. Fourth one, doing assignments. In every week, I will give you 10 questions about the subject which I taught in the live sessions. 10 questions will cover all details which I taught. You will try to solve them by yourself at the beginning. I will send you solutions as well. You will compare your solutions with mine. You have to be careful about two things in coding. First one, your code should work as expected. For example, I gave you a task to print even integers on the console. You did solution. You should click on run button. Your code should print even integers on the console. If you can do it, it means you completed the task. And then you will look at my solution. If my solution is same with yours, it is okay. If my solution is better than yours, please learn my solution. If you think your solution is better than mine, please let me know. I want to look at it. Okay? You shouldn't miss the assignments. And one more thing, everybody. The assignments I will give you will be solved by our instructors once in a week in development recap sessions. Okay. Our instructor will solve all questions in the homework in a development recap session. If you understand everything in the live session and if you can complete the assignments, make sure the subject is completed for you. No worries about it. Okay, fifth one, this is very common sentence used in the United States, especially in education. Teach more, learn more. There are some research about that one. Can you see? Just listening lecture is 5% effective. If you try to learn the subject by reading, it is 10% effective. Audio and visual resources are 20% effective. Please come to the bottom, teaching others 90% effective. If you teach someone else, the someone else will benefit from you. It is okay. but actually you will benefit from teaching. If you are not sure about a subject, for example, if statements, tell to your friends, hey, my dear friends, I want to do a mentoring session about if statements on Monday at 3 p.m., for example. If someone wants to attend, you are welcome. Make preparation to teach if statements. While you make preparation, you will learn all details. And then you will prepare questions, slides. It will make perfect if statement for you. And then you will teach to your friends. While you teach, it will be more than perfect. And then in your instruction, your friends will ask you some questions which you couldn't think about that part. Maybe you will not answer that kind of questions, no worries. Open Google together your friends, look for the answer for the question. If that part was not explained by me in the live session, let me know. I will explain it in the next sessions. Okay, teaching more means learning more. Please try to teach to your friends. If you wanna teach to a group, we can provide you Zoom link. We can help you about announcements. I don't want that one for Tech Pro Education. I want that one just for you guys. Okay. Boot camps need to study hard. Its name is camp. Every time in camps, schedule will be intensive. You will work harder according to real life. It is very normal. In boot camps, there are two main parts. First one is instruction part. It is our responsibility. Second one is self-study part. It is your responsibility. If the instruction is perfect, but you are not studying by yourself, you can learn the subject just as a general culture. You cannot be developer, but you may have some general information about the Salesforce development or admin. If you wanna get offer just after boot camp ends, you should do self-study. It is must. This is the first day. I am telling you, if you will not do self-study, no need to go on in the boot camp. You can cancel your registration. Because if the instruction is perfect, but you are not studying by yourself, you cannot learn. Think like that. You are going to the Harvard University. Harvard is a perfect university, but you are just attending to live sessions. You are not doing your assignments. You are not studying by yourself. You will fail in Harvard. When you fail in Harvard, it is not Harvard's fault. It is your fault. It is your mistake. Okay. Let us talk about the second scenario. Instruction is not perfect, but you are studying hard. You can learn it, everybody. You can learn it. As you know, from low-level schools, some students Can be doctor, can be lawyer, it is possible. Actually, it is not school's success, it is student's success. Same can be in boot camps. Think like that. Instruction is not perfect. There are many errors on the instruction, but you are studying very hard. You can be Salesforce developer. But first scenario is impossible. Second scenario has probability. Okay. No worries. As a tech for education, we are doing boot camps almost 4 years. This is 8 batches, everybody. We have experience in teaching IT. I think we are almost perfect. Nothing is perfect in the world, as you know. Even you go to Harvard, you can find some mistakes on Harvard. It is possible. Tech for education is famous about education quality. You will see it by the time. Everything is almost perfect. But we will get feedbacks from you if you ask to make better some things. We will work on them. But sometimes students ask something, it cannot be realized or it needs time. You should be patient and understandable about that kind of issues. Okay. Seventh one, mentoring is essential in boot camps. In the first one, I told you attending to live session is very important. Everybody, attending to mentoring sessions is maybe more than attending to live instruction sessions. Why? Because in the live instruction sessions, we are teaching a specific subject. You may recover it by watching recordings, it is possible. But in mentoring sessions, you are working with a team. In IT, everyone works in a team. If there is any problem in the application, team is responsible about it, not a specific person. For example, in my team, I am typing a code. My other two friends are checking my code. They are approving my code. And then I am pushing my code into the application. I typed, two others approved. Three of us are responsible about the code. This is team collaboration. This is team working. We want you to learn as a team in mentoring sessions. If you don't attend to mentoring sessions, you cannot learn team working by watching recordings. It is impossible. This is the first thing. Second thing, mentoring groups will be very small, about 15 or 20, between 15 and 20. In a very small group, you can ask very specific questions to your mentor or to your friends. Maybe it is difficult to ask in large groups some things, but in small groups, they are your very close friends. You can easily tell, I couldn't understand that coding. It is very difficult for me. You can talk like that because they are your close friends. But in a large group, it is difficult to tell that one. In that warm area, you can complete your missings. This is the second benefit. If you need any help, your mentor can help you. Or your mentor can assign one of your friends in the group to help you. Third benefit to attend mentoring sessions is interview preparation. When you learn a subject in live sessions, our mentors will teach you related interview questions. If you don't attend, you will miss interview questions part. Don't think like that. After completing boot camp, I will study for interview one more month. I couldn't see anyone who can do it. Because in the boot camp, you will be so tired, everybody. After ending boot camp, you will think like that. I wanna get rest a couple of days, and those days will not end, and you will forget the details what you learned in the boot camp. Don't do it. When you learn for loop, learn interview questions about for loop. When you learn many-to-many relationship, learn interview questions related with the many-to-many relationship. It will be done in mentoring sessions. Don't miss them. And another thing, in a boot camp, you cannot proceed alone. It is a new area. The schedule is so intensive. Constantly you will learn new things, and sometimes you will be frustrated. You will want to give up. When you want to give up, one of your friends will tell you, no worries, I was thinking like that in the last week, but for now, I handled all problems. We can do it together. And your mentor will help you when you think giving up. Okay, this is the other benefit. Our mentors have a schedule to teach you, like our instructors. Please don't miss even one of the mentoring sessions. Our mentors will send you messages to attend mentoring sessions. Our mentors will call you to attend mentoring sessions. But if you insist not to attend mentoring sessions, they will send you an email like, we are calling you and sending you messages, but you are not attending to mentoring sessions. Could you please about not to attend to mentoring sessions after now? Because sending messages, calling students is taking too much time for our mentors. For example, if a student is not attending to mentoring sessions for 5 sessions, for example, we can send an email. Don't make us tired. If you will not attend, no need to call you, no need to send you a message. Because everyone is adult, actually it is not good to call an adult about attending live session, attending mentoring sessions. I think almost all of us have kids. We tell to our kids, don't miss the live sessions. Listen to instructor carefully. Don't miss group workings. We give some advices to our students. Now, please go in front of a mirror and then tell those advices which you are telling to your kids, to yourself, okay? Okay, being positive is must to get success. If you are negative in any area, it is impossible to be successful. All of us are human, and human can do mistakes, human can do, can forget some things. It is very normal. As an instructor, I am human being. You asked a question on the Slack channel. I solved the question, but I was teaching. I thought like that. I will answer that question after completing that subject. But I completed the subject and I forgot to reply your question. It is my mistake. It is very normal. I am a human. I can do that kind of mistakes. Don't think like that. Mr. Süleyman is ignoring us. He replied Ahmet's question. He didn't reply my question. This is the second time Mr. Süleyman is doing that to me. What kind of instructor is he? Don't think like that. Be positive. I know Mr. Süleyman doesn't ignore anyone. Most probably he forgot to reply my question. I will ask it again. You can do that one. Okay. Or TechPro Education has different departments. Technical support department, customer service department, accounting department, mentoring department, career coaching department. You can have some problems with any department. Please try to be positive. I called my mentor yesterday, but he didn't reply my call and he didn't call me back. Maybe he forgot. It's possible. Okay. But you are trying to be positive, but the events convinced you there is a problem in TechPro Education. You can call that number. This is our customer service number. You can call them. You can send WhatsApp message to them, or you can send email. Every feedback, every feedback, we are trying to find a solution about every feedback. No worries about it. Don't share problems on public area. For example, on the live channel, don't type negative messages. The problem is just related with you, not related with everyone. Why are you typing negative things in live channel and giving negativity to others? No need to demotivate your friends. You can send the problems to me from private channel or through customer service. It is possible. Okay. If you tell I cannot do it, you cannot. If you tell I can do it, you can. Okay. For technical support, you can reach out to Mr. Abdullah or Mr. Ender. They are ready to help you. On Slack, if you send message at technical support tech, Mr. Abdullah and Mr. Ender will be notified. They will send you back. This is the first one. Or in Slack, you have technical support channel. If you type your messages in technical support channel, our technical support team will be notified and they will call you back about helping you. But sometimes you may need to wait. It's possible because, for example, Mr. Abdullah is helping to another student. It will take 10 minutes, 20 minutes. You may need to wait. It's possible. But you will be satisfied in our technical team. No worries about it. This is very important, everybody. On the bootcamp, you will use some platforms. For example, you will use your computer. You will use your second screen, second monitor. You will use your Salesforce developer account. If your computer is not working, it means you will miss the live session. Please check your settings 30 minutes before the live session. At least 30 minutes. If you have any issue about your platforms, try to solve it. If you cannot, ask help from our technical support team. Okay. Sometimes the session is starting, one of the students is sending me a message. My Salesforce developer account is broken. I cannot open it. Everybody, during the live session, I can do nothing because you are a single person and there are many other students. I cannot tell to the others, wait for me, I will help to Mr. Ahmet. I cannot do that one. It is not fair. Okay. If you ask help from our technical support, it will take 20 minutes. While you try to solve your issue in 20 minutes, you will miss my instruction. After missing 20 minutes, you will attend to the live session and you will tell me, hey, Mr. Süleyman, I missed first 20 minutes. Could you please repeat it? It is not fair again. Okay. To solve that kind of problems, please check all of your settings 30 minutes before the live session. I think 30 minutes will be enough to fix. But if you think it can take too much time, you can check it 60 minutes before the live session is possible. Okay, Mesuda asked a good question. Do we need to use two monitors during the live session? Yes, it is almost must, everybody. Because when we start to type codes will have many details. To see details on a single small screen is creating issues most of the times, or it is decreasing your speed. You are constantly telling me, Mr. Süleyman, be slow, be slow, be slow. Other students are telling, everything is okay, we are typing in the given time, but that guy cannot type, we are waiting for it constantly. To be faster, using two monitors is very beneficial. No need to buy two laptops. One laptop and another monitor connected with the laptop is enough. Actually, if you have smart TV at your home, you can use it as a second monitor. Okay. Eleventh one is also very essential, everybody. You should check your email inbox and Slack messages in the morning every day. In IT area, nobody calls you by phone. Your manager will send you an email and then he will think, I informed Mr. Ahmet, that's it. If you don't do your tasks according to the email, your manager will tell you, why didn't you do I told you in the email? You cannot tell them, sir, if you could call me, it would be better. I am not checking my inbox. You cannot tell that one. In IT area, email and Slack are communication tools. If you send someone a Slack message, that's enough. No need to call him. No need to send WhatsApp message to him. That's enough. We are doing same in the boot camp. For example, one of our instructors got COVID and we couldn't replace. We will inform you about the instruction. It is canceled, for example. To inform you, we will send a message in announcement channel. That's enough. You shouldn't tell me why are you calling us? Why are you sending, aren't you sending messages through WhatsApp? We will not do that one. We will inform you every time by email and by Slack messages. And every day in the morning, you should check your inbox. For example, in my daily schedule, after waking up, I open my laptop, I check my inbox and Slack messages, and then I start to do my tasks. Maybe one of my tasks canceled in the email. It is not sensible to work on canceled tasks. Okay. 11th one, we will learn how to use Slack. We will learn how to create bookmark. Okay. Let me stop presentation. Okay, I will take the Slack over here. Okay, this is our live channel, everybody. Let me zoom in. When you wanna send a message, you will type it over here. Hi, for example. When I press enter or that arrow icon, it came over here, as you see. This is public message. When I type that message, everyone in the channel will see that message. This is public message, everybody. If I want Nuri, for example, to be notified and all the others see my message, I can do that one. For example, at Nuri. Hi, Nuri. For example, I assigned your first task to Ali, for example. Okay. This is important. Let me do that one as well. Do we have Ali? I don't know. Alpay. You Ali. Okay. Can you see? Nuri should be notified because Nuri's assignment canceled. Ali should be notified because I gave a new task to Ali. Both of them should be notified. And the group should know Nuri's task was assigned to Ali. If you need that kind of messages, you can use that one. This is public message. This is public with notifications. Another one, everybody. I will create semi-public message. For example, I am sending Nuri a message. Click on that one, please. Reply in thread, it says. Click on that one. And then I will type over here, hi, for example. I am sending it. Can you see the message is not visible at the beginning? But if I wanna see it, I can click on it and see it. Can you see hi displayed over here? When do we do that one? I think the message doesn't need to be public. But maybe someone wants to read it. If you think like that, you can make it. For example, Nuri asked me a question. What is the meaning of static keyword? Actually, I explained that one in the live session, but most probably Nuri forgot it. I will type over here, static keyword is that one. Okay. I put it over here. Why am I doing like that? Because maybe there are other students forgot the meaning of static. If they wanna see it, they can. I didn't make it public. No need to others to focus on static keyword. They know it. Just Nuri and maybe a couple of students forgot it. For that kind of scenarios, you can use semi-public messages. Okay. That one. And another one, direct message, everybody. Click on plus sign over here. Today, I will proceed with Nuri. Nuri, I selected it. Can you see it says this conversation is just between the two of you. This is private conversation, everybody. Nobody can see that message if you send it like that. In the companies, even your managers cannot see that messages, but I am not sure about that. Maybe they did something and followed the private messages. It is possible. When you start to work in a company, be careful about even private messages. One more thing about sending messages. Using uppercases means yelling in IT. For example, if I tell over here, did you do what I told? If you type the message like that, yes, Mehmet Yıldırım, look at the screen. There are two groups in the live session. I am using Slack of another group, but you can follow the screen. Pay attention, please. If you type the code like that, it means you are you are yelling, you are so angry. Don't do that one. Type the message like that. Hi, kindly reminding, could you complete the task? Please let me know. Thanks, everybody. In IT area, when you send messages, at the beginning, tell hi, at the end, tell thanks, and please be kind in the message. Okay. Using uppercases is so rude. Don't do it. But when you ask something to someone, please start with greeting, end with ending, and your sentence should be as possible as kind. Okay. This is the correct messaging. Okay. I think that's enough about messaging. I will teach you how to pin a message. For example, this message is very important. This message is very important. I sent that message. And then I wanna store that message in the channel to use later as well. How can I do it? Click on three dots over here and then pin to channel. When I click on it, its color is being yellow, as you see. Where is that message stored? Can you see at the top on the left, it says two pins. Click on it. This is our Zoom link. Can you see our technical support? Put the Zoom link over here. And this is my message. I think this message is very important. You can reach that kind of important messages out by using pinned storage. Okay, that one. If you wanna delete, you can click on cross sign. It is for unpinning. Can you see? Remove. Now I have one pinned one. There are two important things in pinned part. Don't unpin someone else's pinned message, because Zoom link is very important for me. I pinned it. Don't unpin it. Okay, it can be a problem. Second thing, everybody, if something is not important, don't pin it. Okay, don't make pinned storage like a trash can. Just essential and important things should be pinned. And pin storage has limitation. You cannot put more than 100 messages into pin storage. Because of that, be careful if you wanna pin something. Actually, don't use it. Mostly mentors, instructors, our technical team, career coaching team will use that part. If you think something is very important, you can pin, no restriction. This is the pinned part. Okay. One more thing, everybody. Can you see we created a fun channel over here? Why did we create that one? Because we want all messages related with the Salesforce in live channel. But you are students, you wanna get fun, or you found a very fun recording in YouTube about Salesforce, you wanna share it with your friends, don't share it in live channel. Don't share it in a helping each other channel. Share that kind of fun messages in fun channel, okay? That's it. Another one, helping each other. Helping each other. Over here, you sent messages just related with help requests. I gave you 10 questions. You couldn't solve seventh one. You put a message over here. Hi, everyone. Hi, everyone. Is there anybody solved 8th question in the last assignment, for example? When you send the message, all students will see your message. If there is someone who solved 8th question, he will share the solution over here. You will get help from your friends. Okay, that's it. Okay, helping each other channel is for that one. And there is, actually there was, but I think it is removed. There is one more channel, which is code sharing channel. Everybody. In code sharing channel, I will share the codes I typed during the live session. If you miss any part, you can get the codes from code sharing channel. Okay. And announcement channel, we will do important announcements over here. For example, can you see? I put that one, this is slide to create Salesforce developer account. Okay. You will find that kind of important things in announcement channel. Or can you see our technical support team shared Sublime Text Editor, you should install it into your local computer. It is not must for today, but if you can, it will be good. Okay, I told you that one is technical support, as you see. If you want any technical support, you can send message over there. Okay. And I will teach you how to delete a message, but you will not have deletion permission, everybody. I will have delete option. Can you see? I will delete it. When will I delete a message? If a message has political ideas, we will delete them directly. Someone can like Trump, someone can fall in love with Biden. Everybody, it is personal thoughts. No need to share them. We will delete that kind of messages directly. Second one, we will delete negative messages directly. I told you, negative things should be shared with the related team, with the related person. No need to make negative ideas public. Okay, I will delete them. One more thing, negative organizations. Students cannot do negative organizations. What I mean, for example, we don't want that instructors. Let us do a survey about the instructors. Don't do it. That kind of negative organizations will be deleted on Slack. If you have any issue about an instructor, which is possible, let us know, let customer service know. We will find a solution about it, no worries, okay? And if you send some messages which contains some rude words or you don't do it, but some curses, they will be deleted as well, okay? And if a message was sent to a wrong channel, I will delete it. For example, Miss Mahide sent a message over here, but it is not helping, it is not asking help. That message is not related with the helping each other channel. I will delete them because channels should be clean. If a channel has many unrelated messages, it is being difficult to find what you are looking for. Okay. We will keep the channels clean. For example, that message actually related, but for now I am not asking help. I will delete it as well. Okay, that's it. And everybody, let me check. Okay, now I will show you how to share codes. If you share the codes, everybody, like a regular message, the code doesn't work most of the times. Why? Because codes have some special characters. When you send it as a regular message, Slack is breaking specific characters to something else, and then the code is not running. How can you share a code? You will click on plus sign. Can you see create a text snippet over here? Can everybody see? Create a text snippet. You can let me know with Slack message. If you don't see, I will show you another way. Okay. Everyone is able to see, I think. Okay. Click on create a text snippet, please. And then let us type over here an Apex code. System.debug. Put semicolon to the end. Between the single quotes, I will type I. This is very simple Apex code. Let me share it with you. That one. After putting the code inside the content text area, okay, and then from the type dropdown, you should select Java. Select Java, please. Normally, I should select Apex, but Slack application didn't put Apex yet. But Apex is Java-based programming language. Because of that, you can select Java. Can you see when I select Java, it colored high, it made it red. And then click on create snippet. Okay. It is taking time. Can you see? My code is over here. It may take time. You couldn't see create snippet. Okay, Irana. Click on browse all shortcuts. If you cannot see create a text over here, click on browse all shortcuts. Zeynep, you can click on it. Browse all shortcuts and then click on Slack, that one. It will display you all shortcuts. You can select create a text snippet from here. When you use create a text snippet, a couple of times it will put it at the top. Zeynep, I am explaining again. Okay, I am explaining. Click on plus sign. Browse all shortcuts. Click on it, please. And then click on Slack. You will see create a text snippet over here. When you click on it, it will open that one. Zeki, could you do it? And Hanife, and Irana. Okay, perfect. Okay, Hanife, follow me one more time. Click on browse all shortcuts, Hanife. Click on the highlighted one. And then click on Slack, that one. And then scroll down and find create a text snippet. When you select it, it will open create snippet window. Okay. You will learn it, no worries. After the live session, you can play with Slack with different functionalities. Okay, now I will teach you how to share something from your local computer in Slack. Please click on plus icon. Click on plus icon. And then at the bottom, can you see it says upload from your computer? Select it, please. upload from your computer. Can you see it opened my folders in my local computer? I will select anyone from here, for example. Let me share an image with you. If I can find. Those are screenshots. Okay. I will share that one, for example. Can you see I shared an image, everybody, on Slack. If you need to share any file folder from your local computer, you can do it like that. Let me show the steps. Upload from your computer and then select any file or folder, click on open, it will send it through Slack. Okay, that's it. Break is after 9 minutes, Zeki. Every session is 80 minutes, as you know, and you will have 10 minutes break time between first and second sessions. After the second session, you will have 40 minutes lunch break. Perfect. Rabia shared the schedule. Okay. Okay, I taught you how to share folders as well. Let me show you one more thing. This is my message, for example. Okay. By using bold button, you can bold any word, any character. You know that one. It is same with Microsoft Word. I is for making italic. Okay, that's it. Pay attention. That one is important, everybody. For example, I wanna make that part emphasized. You can use that one. Okay. Can you see it is making is and my like code in red. Okay. And that one, click on it. It made it like a code again. It removed red. If you use that one, it will make it red. Okay. It is being like a code in red. You can use those. In real life, where are we using that two things? For example, I am informing others about deployments. I am telling, I will deploy, for example, tap.bot app to QA, for example. I want everyone to be notified about that one. I am typing it like that. Because deployment is a process. If someone deploys, others shouldn't. If you deploy someone else over the someone else's deploy, it will be problem for the first deployment. Because of that, when we do anything deploy, we should inform everyone in the company and which application are you deploying, you should inform them. We make it like that. Okay, for Slack, that's enough, everybody. You will use Slack almost every day. You will be expert in Slack, no worries. Okay, and the last thing before the break is how to create bookmark. Okay, I will open a Google browser. Please open a Google browser. Can you see over here I have many browsers, everybody? Sorry, bookmarks. I have many bookmarks. That one, that one. Those are browsers. Why did I, those are bookmarks. Why did I create those bookmarks? Because I am looking at my Yahoo inbox many times in a day. No need to type www.yahoo.com every time. I created a bookmark just by clicking on that bookmark. I am being able to see my inbox. It makes my life easier. Okay. For example, I am navigating to TechPro Education website many times in a day. I put it over here as bookmark. Okay. Can you see? That one was our previous web address. We changed it to techproeducation.com. Actually, I should update the bookmark. Can you see this is our website? I didn't type www.techproeducation.com. By the help of the bookmark, I am able to reach out to any website. You can do it. Pay attention. You will use a Salesforce login website almost every day. Create a bookmark about it. No need to type www.salesforce.com again and again. Just click on the bookmark. It will take you to Salesforce login page. How can you create bookmark? After opening web page once, there is a star icon at the top on the right. Can you see? That one. There is a star icon. This is. Click on it, please. Click on star icon. That one. And then it gives you the name automatically. If you want, you can update it. For example, I want to make it short. No need to make it long like that. And I don't want to use space. I updated the name. When you click on done, it is done, everybody. On my browser, I have many bookmarks. The others are over here. Click on the hidden bookmarks button. Can you see? It will display techproeducation.com. Where is it? It is at the end. Can you see over here? Create bookmarks to access commonly used web pages. Salesforce login web page should be bookmarked, I think. And you can bookmark your Zoom link as well. Actually, I will share the Zoom link 5 minutes before the session starts every time. But you can be late for the session, 5 minutes, 10 minutes. No need to ask to your friends, where is Zoom link? Create bookmark. Click on it, come to the live session. Okay. Melike, I think our technical support team added registered student to helping each other. Because of that, you cannot see. But our technical team will inform you right now. Okay, let us give 10 minutes break time, everybody. After the break time, we will start to talk about programming languages, okay? And we will start to talk about Apex. In Apex sessions, you will use same link. In admin sessions, you will use another link. Every instructor will use his own Zoom link. Today, the link which I shared and it is pinned on Slack channel will be used in all APEC sessions. Okay, see you after 10 minutes, everybody. Hi, everybody. Break time is over. We will start to talk about what the programming language is. Programming language is a language. Learning process is very similar with learning English, learning French, learning German. Nothing is difficult to understand, but everything needs to review again and again. When you learn English, every rule is very easy to understand. But to be able to speak English, you should review the rules, you should do practice. If you do more practice, your English will be better. Same is in programming language. Rules will be very easy. You will understand them easily. No worries about it. But if you don't review, if you don't practice, you will forget them. And after some times, maybe you will think programming language is so hard. Actually not, but it needs practice. Okay. In English, for example, our friend is telling us, come here. What is happening after my friend told, come here? My brain is extracting the meaning of that sentence, and then my brain is sending me the meaning. According to the meaning, I am starting to act. This is the flow in English. Similar flow is in programming languages. Instead of come here, I will type APEC codes. The codes will be understood by development kit. Development kit is like a brain of programming languages. Development kit will convert the APEC codes to zero and ones. Why? Because computer machine can understand just from zeros and ones. Zero means no electricity. One means there is electricity. Computer is a machine. It is working with electricity. If there is electricity, it will understand. It means one. If there is no electricity, it will understand it is zero. The process to convert APEC codes to zero and ones is compile. When I tell you compile, you will understand APEC codes converted to zero and ones. If you type the code wrong, development kit cannot understand the code. development kit cannot convert the code to zero and ones. This is called compile error. Okay. This is called compile error. For example, instead of come here, I am telling something weird. For example, XXX here. I thought something like that. A brain cannot understand the meaning, and then the guy will tell you, what do you mean? This is error, everybody. The guy is giving error. What does it mean? If you don't change XXX to come, it will give you error constantly. Same thing in programming language. If you do any mistake in code, development kit cannot convert your code to zero and ones, and then it tells you, what do you mean? It will tell you, you have a problem on your code, fix it please. You will get that kind of messages. When you type code without any error, development kit will convert it to zero and ones. Your computer machine will understand the meaning from zero and ones, and then it will start to act. Is there any question about the flow of programming languages and the meaning of compile? If you don't have, I will proceed to the next slide. Okay, I am proceeding. What is APEX, everybody? APEX is Java-based programming language. As you know, Salesforce creates enterprise applications. In every enterprise application, there are three main segments, everybody. Three main segments. First one is CRM segment. CRM means, everybody, let me open the slide, it will be better. Okay, I couldn't find it, no problem. In every enterprise application, you will have three segments. First segment is CRM. CRM stands for Customer Relationship Management. That part will focus on everything about customer relationship. For example, getting feedback is related with customer relationship. Salesforce will focus on. Second segment in enterprise applications is marketing. Third one is business side, everybody. Normally, Salesforce could use Java, but Java is very huge programming language. By using Java, you can create many applications, not just enterprise applications. But Salesforce focused on enterprise applications and thought Java is so large for my task. Salesforce simplified Java and got the part related with the enterprise application, made some updates on it, and then created APEX programming language. Because of that, Apex is easier than Java. Apex is smaller than Java. But Apex can do everything about enterprise applications. Java is easy programming language. Apex is easier than Java. Okay. And second feature of Apex is being strongly typed programming language. What does it mean? For example, if I tell you H equals to 12, you can easily understand 12 is an integer, and for H, we should use integers. You can understand that one easily. But if you are using strongly typed programming language, you have to declare data type of 12. If 12 is integer, you have to declare it. This is strongly typed programming language. Okay. For example, you are telling name equals to Ali, for example. You can easily understand Ali is not integer, Ali is not decimal, Ali is a word. You can understand that one. But in strongly typed programming languages, you have to declare its data type, which is string. In programming languages, for words, we use string data type. We will learn them a bit details later. But for now, just as a general culture, you can understand that one. Okay. I hope the meaning of strongly typed is clear for everyone. Is it okay? You can send yes or just why, it will be enough. Without getting confirmation, I will not proceed to the next step. Okay. Now, everybody, another thing about Apex, this is the third feature, okay? Apex is case insensitive programming language. What does it mean? If you type system with uppercase S or lowercase s, there is no difference according to Apex. According to Apex, Ali with all characters in uppercases, Ali with all characters in lower cases, Ali is capitalized, Ali is like that. Everybody, all of them are same according to Apex, because Apex is case insensitive programming language, not sensitive. Okay. And fourth feature of Apex is OOP, object-oriented programming language. This is very important. You should understand general concept of object-oriented programming languages, and in the next sessions, we will learn object-oriented programming language concept with details. But for now, I will tell you a couple of sentences about OOP concept. Okay. When you establish a business, you have two options. First option is object oriented. Second option is process oriented. In object oriented businesses, employees are essential. You think like that. If the employees are perfect, everything will work perfectly. This is object-oriented concept, everybody. Let me do it like that. Over here, process is not so important. If the people are good, everything will work perfectly. There will be no any problem. For example, Turkish restaurants, everybody, Turkish restaurants uses perfect cookers. If the cooker is perfect, taste will be perfect. You will earn money from the business. But if the cooker leaves the business, and if you cannot find a cooker same with the previous one, customers will not like the new taste, and they will look for another restaurants. You will start to lose in the business. This is object-oriented concept. In process-oriented, employees are not so important. Process is important. Over here, process is important. In Starbucks, everybody, in Starbucks, there is no coffee cooker. They made the system perfect. Anyone can work in Starbucks as a coffee maker after a short training. Starbucks is not object-oriented, but Turkish restaurants are object-oriented. Okay. Apex is object-oriented programming language. In Apex, objects are essential. When you wanna create an application, you must focus on objects. In that application, which objects I will use, you will decide them. And then you will think about the characteristics of the objects. Characteristics can be passive characteristics, active characteristics. What I mean, passive characteristics can be like hair color, eye color, or height, weight. Those can be passive characteristics of an object. And active characteristics, speaking, running, walking, eating, drinking, those are active characteristics. So when you create an application in Apex, you have to create object first. And then you have to add characteristics to your object in two types, passive characteristics, active characteristics. You will have that kind of objects, and then you will put them together and you will have an application by using Apex. Okay. For example, over here, I have a perfect cooker. I have a perfect manager. I have a perfect waiter, for example. Okay. If the people are perfect, everything will perfect. This is the logic of OOP concept. OOP concept is similar with Legos, everybody. Legos. For example, over here, can you see there is a blue object over here. That object has two characteristics. First one is passive characteristics. That one is passive characteristics. Second one is active characteristics. Let us talk about the passive characteristics first. For example, color of the part. What else? Shape, for example. What else? Size. Okay. Those are passive characteristics, everybody. And let us talk about active characteristics. For example, it will move. If you put it, for example, into the engine, it should move. Or, for example, it will turn. If you put it into the tire, it needs to turn. Those are active characteristics. In Apex, but in Apex, passive characteristics are called variables. Okay. When I tell you variables, you will understand passive characteristics of an object, and active characteristics are called methods or function. You can hear function as well, but mostly I will use methods. Okay. When you tell methods, it means active characteristics of the object. Okay. Is object-oriented programming concept clear, everybody? I mean red, yellow ones. Clear? Okay. Is variable and method clear? What the variable is, what the method is, clear or not? Okay. So I will proceed one more step. Pay attention, please. You will create many objects over here, like Legos. You will create many objects, and then by putting the objects together, you will have a toy. In IT area, toy will be application. Okay. So what is the process in programming languages when you wanna create an application? Create objects, put passive and active features into it. I mean, variables and methods into it. And then integrate the objects. After integration completed, if everything is done correctly, you will have an application which does whatever you want. This is object-oriented programming language concepts. If you don't have any question about that slide, I will proceed to the next one. I told you You have to create object first. How can I create an object? How can I create an object? This is a coin. Coin is an object. If I tell you create a coin, you will ask a template from me. You will tell me, Mr. Süleyman, to create that coin, I need a template. Please give me the template, then I will create the object. Okay. So, to create an object, we need template. Can you see? First one is the template for first object. In programming languages, templates are called class. When I tell you class, you will understand template to create objects. Is this clear, the meaning of class? If there is no, it means everyone is understanding. Yes, in real life, Latif, to create an object, we use templates. In programming languages, to create an object, we use classes. So, class means templates. That's it, everybody. Pay attention, please. In the template, there is nose. Can you see? Nose. In the object, there is nose as well. In the template, there is eye over here. In the object, there is eye. So, whatever I want on object, I have to have them in classes as well. If you don't put nose on template, it is impossible to have nose on object. So I told you, in an object, we should have variables and methods. So in templates, I mean in classes, you must have variables and functions. Functions and methods are synonyms. Okay. Let me change that one to methods. Okay. Again, variables are for passive characteristics. Methods are for active characteristics. If your object is coin, active characteristics can be to buy, to travel, to eat, something like that. Passive characteristics will be size, shape, color, those are. Okay. To create an application, before object, I have to create class. So what is the flow? Create class. By using classes, create objects. And then add active and passive features to objects, and then put the objects together, create the application. This is the flow in application creation. I hope that slide is okay for everyone. When do we need Apex? Salesforce has two main parts. One is admin part. The other is development part. In admin part, you will not type any code. You will use existing functionalities. Salesforce knows common features of enterprise applications. Salesforce created functionalities in admin part. If you wanna put any functionality in your application, you will get and use it. You will not type any code in admin part. But every application can need some specific features. For example, Salesforce created 100 different login button. Square login button, rectangle login button, circular login button, Eclipse login button created many options. But I want a different login button. It will be like a star, for example. And Salesforce didn't put it in admin part. What should you do? You should type code, create your star login button and use it in the application. Okay. Can you see? I put a simple calculator over here. If I need addition, everybody, if I need addition, no need to do anything. Addition is over here. I can use it directly. When you need addition functionality in Salesforce, okay, no need to type any code. Get and use it. That's it. For example, subtraction functionality, I need that one. I will look at the Salesforce. If Salesforce has subtraction functionality, no need to type code, use it directly. Same is for multiplication, and same is for division. Can you see? Those are coming from Salesforce. But I need square root functionality. Can you see? I need that one. I looked at the Salesforce. In the Salesforce, there is no square root functionality. So I need Apex. After using Apex, I can have square root functionality. Or you are needing percentage functionality. You will look at the Salesforce. There is no percentage functionality over here in the Salesforce. So you will use Apex. You will create your own functionality, then use it. This is the difference between admin part and development part. In Apex applications, admin part is used 70%, everybody. Because of that, Salesforce is being common in the market. You wanna create an application and for 70%, no need to type any code. This is perfect. It will save time, no need to test 70% because they tested by Salesforce and by many other companies many times. For the 30%, everybody, you need to type your own codes. 30%. This is statistics. It can be 31 or 25, but for now, it is 70% and 30%. If you know just admin part, you can look for a position as Salesforce admin. you can look for Salesforce admin positions. It is possible. If you learn development part as well, you can look for Salesforce developer positions. Salesforce developer positions. Okay. If you know both, which is recommended, everybody, you can look for a position like Salesforce admin and developer. IT companies look for employees know many things, because if you know both admin and developer, if the company needs anyone in admin part, it can use you. If the company needs anyone in development part, it can use you. You are being multifunctional, like Swiss Army knife. If you need fork, Swiss Army knife will be fork. If you need spoon, Swiss Army knife will be spoon. Multifunctional. Because of that, in our boot camp, we are teaching both admin and development parts. You should learn both as well. Okay. But if you feel yourself not powerful in development parts, no need to worry. You can find positions just as an admin as well. You can tell them, I know Salesforce development, but I am expert in admin. You can find positions like that. Some of our alumni found positions like that. They told, I know development, but not for powerful, but in admin, I am expert. The company needs admin and they got offer, no problem. But I recommend you to learn both as possible as well. Okay. Second thing about development part, you will step into IT area. In IT area, you should learn a programming language. If you don't know any programming language, it will be difficult to understand IT logic. Among the people, you should know at least a language. If you don't know any language, you can communicate with people by using your body language. It is possible, but not recommended. Same, everybody. If you decided to step into IT world, you should learn at least one programming language to understand the logic of IT guys. I recommend you to be good in Apex. Okay, this is the Apex flow. Normally, when you type a code in Java, no need internet. Without having internet, if you installed IntelliJ into your local computer, you can type codes and run them. It is possible. But in Apex, everything is in cloud. You will type a code and then click on run button. Your code will go to the server in cloud. Can you see in the image? This is developer. Developer typed codes over here. Let me make it like that. Developer typed codes. Can you see the codes will go to the server in cloud through internet? By using internet, it is going to the server. What will happen in the server? Can you see it says compiler? What will compiler do? It will check your codes. If they are typed correctly, it will convert them to zero and ones. Those will be done in cloud. Because of that, you will see sometimes we will type code, we will click on run button, it will wait a couple of seconds. Why? Because it is going to the cloud by internet. It will be compiled in the server, and then I will get the message. It is okay or it has problem like that. Okay. If your internet connection is slow, it will take more time to execute your code. I mean, just 2 or 3 seconds. Sometimes you will need to wait. Okay, after code compiled, I mean converted to zero and ones, and then it will be sent to the storage, data storage. Your code will be stored in your server. Okay. Apex will give you a server for every customer, and then your code will be stored over there. And new codes will be integrated to the existing codes. It means you are completing your application step by step. When you complete everything about your application in your server, you will have an application which works. Okay. This is the red flow. This is happy scenario. There is no any error in codes. They are compiled in the application server and then the data stored. Let us talk about negative scenario. In negative scenario, developer will type codes. Let me make it like that. Okay. Developer typed codes. By using internet, the codes will go to the server. Okay. Compiler will understand there is error in the code. For example, you forgot to put semicolon to the end. Or you would type system, you type system, for example. You made a typo. Compiler will understand the error, and then it will send back the code to you by using internet. Can you see? Compiler errors. It will tell to the developer, hey, developer, your code is wrong. What will developer do? Developer will fix the code. Okay. Will fix the code. And then will send it to the compiler again over here. If everything is okay about your code, it will be converted to zero and ones, and then it will be stored in the data storage. That negative flow will be repeated until you fix all errors. Okay. Even very small error, Apex doesn't accept your code. Every time your code will be rejected. Okay. In the first part, I talked about application creation. In the second part, we will talk about using completed application. What will happen in the second part? Can you see this is user? This user will send a request. User doesn't type any code. User will enter his username, password, and then click on login button. By clicking on login button, user will send the application a request. What kind of request? I want to log into the application. This is the request. It will send the request. That request will come to the server. Server will check the request. Everybody. Apex runtime. It will check the request. If the request is confirmed, you will be able to go storage. Whatever data you wanna get from there, you will get it, and then it will come to the end user. Okay. For example, if your username and password is correct, it means this is happy scenario, you will be able to access database, and then in the database, you will have many data about you. If it is a banking application, you will have your balance, you will have your accounts, you will have your password, your edit profile things, many things you will have. You will be able to work with them. But if username and password or any one of them is wrong, application will not you to let data related with the user. You will not see balance, you will not see accounts, you will not see profile, nothing. Okay, this is the flow of end user. As you see, without having internet, you cannot use Apex, you cannot type any code. Is there any question about that slide, everybody? Of course, Barış, Salesforce created a platform to make Salesforce perfect. Salesforce put many rules. Salesforce has some application standards. If you don't create your application in Salesforce standards, Salesforce will reject it. Because you are creating your application, but there is Salesforce signature in it. Salesforce thinks like that. I will sign that application. It must be in my standards. If you don't create the application in Salesforce standards, it is impossible to proceed even one more step. In Salesforce application creation, there are 15 steps. You will learn them in admin part. One of the 15 steps is making application in Salesforce standards. First step means, I didn't mention 15 steps. It is admin part subject, not development part. Okay. This is the flow, everybody. Data, I know everyone has idea about the meaning of data, but let us learn it theoretically, because we will use data many times in coding part. Everybody, data is information processed or stored in a computer. For example, You will create a class to use it as a template to create object. You will create a class. Class will be data. Why? Because data, sorry, class will be used in my computer. I will store class in my computer. It is called data. By using class, you created an object. Object is a data because I will process object, I will store object in my application. It is called data. You created passive characteristic of an object, which is variable. Variable is a data. Because I will work with variable in my application. I will store the variable in my application. Methods are data. Because I will process them, I will store them. So when you work with a programming language, you may think like that. Everything is data. Everything I used is data. Everything I produced is data. Okay. So programming languages uses data, produces data. Apex does the same, uses data, produces data. Everything is data in Apex, in programming languages, and to protect data is very important in applications, and Salesforce has its own security settings. When you type, when you create an application, Salesforce tells you, use fake data in your codes. At the beginning, you will create the application by using dummy data or fake data. Okay. After creating the application by using fake data, Salesforce will check your application if it is in Salesforce standards or not. If the application created by fake data is in Salesforce standards, and then Salesforce will put security on your application. Okay. After putting security, you can use actual data in your application. Without putting security, Salesforce doesn't let you to use actual data because actual data can be stolen if there is no security. Salesforce sets everything, everybody, about enterprise applications, every details. Because of that, it is improving so fast. Microsoft established in 1975, as you know. Salesforce established in 1999, 24 years after Microsoft. But Salesforce is the fourth largest company in the world right now. And it is increasing its popularity every single day. Okay. I hope data is clear for everyone. I am proceeding to the next slide. Okay. Bit and byte. Everybody. Bit and byte. Okay. When we talk about data, we should learn what the bit is and what the byte is. The smallest unit of a data is called bit. Cell for a human is the smallest unit. For data, smallest unit is called bit. Anyway, what can you put into the smallest unit? You can put one or zero. I told you, after I type the code, when I click on execute button, compiler will take role and convert my code to zero and ones. For example, I typed a code over here like that, system.debug, semicolon, and hi, for example. This is a code. What will Apex do? Apex will take my code, convert it to zero and ones. I am putting any numbers over here. Can you see that code was converted to zero and ones? And then every zero and one will be put into bits. One will come over here. Okay. One will come over here. And then next one will come over here. Next one will come over here. Next one will come over here. In a single bit, you can put a single zero or a single one. That's it. As you see, 8 bits, everybody, 2, 4, 6, 8. 8 bits are called bytes. 100 centimeters are called a meter. 8 bits are called bytes. Not to mix, if it has less characters, it is small. If it has more characters, it is larger. Okay. Okay. Now, that part was the introduction of Apex. Now we will start to learn how to create variables. I mean, passive characteristics. And then we will learn how to create methods. And then we will proceed. Okay. We have memory, everybody. This is memory. Pay attention, please. When you type that code, Apex will go to the memory over here. Inside the memory, it will reserve an area. Okay. And it will name the area as age. Why? Because I told age to Apex. This is the name of the variable. I am repeating that part. When you type integer age semicolon, it means you created a reserved area in memory and you made its name as age. The meaning of that code is that one. Let us look at the second one. When I type that code, Apex will go into the memory. It will reserve an area. It will make its name name. Because I made its name name. Variable names depends on you. If you want, for age, you can use my age. You can use my dad's age, my mother's age. There is no any restriction for variable names. You can put whatever you want. But there is general practice in programming languages. The variable name standard is that one. Name should be related with the concept. If you will put into reserved area age, don't make its name height or weight. If you will store age over here, make its name age. When you store age, if you use height as name, definitely your code will be rejected. Your code works, no problem. But reviewers will reject your code. They will tell you, are you kidding? You are storing over here age. Why are you making its name height? Because readability is essential in coding, everybody. When you type code, your code must work. It's okay. Your code must be in coding standards. The first one in coding standards is readability. When I look at your code, I should understand. Miss Mahide created a reserved area in memory. Its name is age. So definitely Miss Mahide will store age in the reserved area. I should understand like that. If you make it ununderstandable, they will reject your code. You cannot tell that one. It is not important. I made it height, but my code is working. They will smile and they will show you the door to exit the company. Okay? If you wanna stay in the company, don't argue with your managers. If they tell you something, almost 100% it is correct. Okay, I hope everyone understood the meaning of that one, string name, integer age. Okay. But in the red part, I talked about just that one, name. I told you a rule about creating variable name, which is it should be related with the concept. Let us talk about the semicolon. I have semicolon over here. In English, when we complete a sentence, we put dot. For example, I went to school and then I put dot because I ended the English sentence. In coding, to declare I ended the sentence, you need to put semicolon. Okay, semicolon is same with dot in sentences. Okay, it is same with the dot in sentences. Pay attention, please. In English, we tell sentence. In coding, we will tell statement. Okay. instead of sentence, you will use statement. When I tell you statement, you will understand like something sentence. Okay, this is statement. For example, over here, that orange one, starting with string, ending with semicolon, is called statement. I have two statements. Red one is a statement, orange one is another statement. And the third part over here, this is. It is data type, everybody. This is data type. When you create a reserved area in memory, you have to tell to Apex, hey, Apex, I wanna store integer in it. So inside the age reserved area, you will store integer. Because Apex will create specific reserved area for every data type. For integers, it will create integer reserved area. For strings, it will create string reserved area. Their structure is different. Because of that, you have to tell to Apex, what kind of data will you store in reserved area? Okay. When you reserve a table in a restaurant, they will ask you, how many visitors will come? Or how many kids are there? How many ladies are there? They may ask that kind of questions. Why? Because they will set the reserved area according to it. Same logic. If you tell Apex it will be string, Apex will set the reserved area according to string. If you tell integer, it will do another setting for integers. So when you wanna create a variable, you have to do three main things. First one, type data type. Second one, put a name for your variable. Third one, don't forget to put semicolon to the end. Okay, look at the orange one. I typed data type. I put a name for my variable. At the end, I put semicolon. Okay, three. Okay. You may ask me that one, you created a reserved area, but you didn't put anything in it. Is that reserved area empty? No, everybody, no. If you create a reserved area, Apex will put null into it automatically. Apex doesn't accept empty reserved area. Every time it puts null in it. For integers, it put null. For strings, it put null. Okay, that one. What is the null? Null is an object which doesn't have passive or active characteristics. You created an object. It doesn't have variables. It doesn't have methods. It is empty object. There is a human in front of you, but he doesn't have hair color. He doesn't have eye color. He doesn't have height. He doesn't have weight. He cannot speak. He cannot drink. He cannot run. He cannot walk. This is null, everybody. In real world, It is impossible to have something like that. But in digital world, you may have objects which doesn't have anything in it. It is null object. And Apex put null into a reserved area as default. If you don't tell Apex age will be 23, Apex will put null over here. Is there any question so far? Okay. Pay attention, please. Can you see I put one more syntax over here to create variables? What will happen when you type the code like that? Let me draw another memory. This is my other memory. Yes, Isa, I am giving you many informations, I know. But as you see, every information is very easy. It is your task to put that easy informations into your mind. Okay? You need to take notes, you need to do reviews, and then you will make it clear. After explaining that one, no need to wait, I think, on it, because it is clear. Why will we wait? We will proceed to the next subject. But if there is anything which is not clear, you can let me know. I can explain it again at most 3 times. Okay. Everybody, when you type that code, what will happen? I am telling to Apex, hey Apex, I need age variable, height variable, distance variable. So Apex will reserve an area for age. Okay. Will reserve another area for height. That one. And we'll reserve another area for distance, everybody. That one. This is the distance reserved area. Okay. What will I put into that reserved area? Can you see it says integer? Integer will work for age, will work for height, will work for distance as well. So over here, I will put integer. I will write it short. That one will be integer. That one will be integer as well. Okay. If you want to make your code shorter, you can use that syntax. If you don't use that syntax, your code will be like that. Your code would be like that. Integer h, integer height, integer distance. That one, everybody, the highlighted one and the code on the left have same functionality. No difference in functionality. But which one is better? Left one is better. Why? As you see over here, I typed integer 3 times. This is repetition, everybody. This is repetition. I am telling you one more coding standard. If it is possible, don't do repetition. Repetition is not good practice in coding standards. I typed integer 3 times over here. This is repetition. But over here, as you see, no repetition. Integer typed just once. It is possible to stop repetition in your code. So I should prefer left one. Okay. What is the rule? Everybody, what is the rule? If you create multiple variables in same data type, use that one. Okay, I am repeating. If you create multiple variables in same data type, use that syntax. Left one works, but it is not recommended. If you type the code like that, the reviewer will not reject it. But if you type the code like that, reviewer will think, oh, that guy is experienced developer because he knows what the coding standards are and types the code according to the coding standards. I told you, programming languages similar with English, Turkish, Russian. Everybody, if I tell you, bring me water, that sentence works. Everyone can understand that sentence and brings me water. It is okay. My code worked. My sentence worked. But that sentence is not sentence standard. Why? Because I should tell like that. Could you please bring me water? This is the standard. We should be kind in our communications. Okay. Same in coding. Don't think like that. My code is working. It can work, but you can disobey the standards. So far, I gave you 2 standards, everybody. First one, that one is second one. To make it short, what was the first one? First coding standard. First coding standard, what was it? Yes, you need to use, everybody, you need to obey, Salesforce rules, okay? For example, when you create a variable, you have to type data type. This is standard, you have to use it. Or you have to put variable name as related with the concept. This is the first one. First one, make the variable names related with the concept. Second one, if it is possible, don't do repetition. Okay. Okay, the time is over, everybody. You have 40 minutes lunch break. Please be online after 40 minutes. According to the United States Eastern Time, you will be online at 1:30 p.m. But some of our students are from different countries. They should be careful about being on time. See you after 40 minutes.